Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So today in this video we are going to create a simple circle burst animation in After Effects. This is very easy to make, won't take more than 3 to 4 steps to recreate this animation, and this animation is very useful and you can use this very frequently in your projects, and these animation will definitely add zest to your project. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So we'll begin with creating a new composition. Now we will add a background to this composition. So purple is the fine color. So now that we have created a background, let us select ellipse tool from this shape menu, and press Control Shift and pull the mouse outward in order to create this circle. Now make sure the fill is set to none, and stroke will be animating, so we'll not worry about the stroke as of now. So make sure the fill is set to none. You can click here and select this none option. Okay, so you can select none and click OK, so you have no fill here. So once we are done with this, now we have to animate the strokes. For that we need to go into the ellipse under shape layer. Now here you can find the stroke property. Click on the drop down menu. Okay, so you have all the properties for stroke, like color, opacity, stroke width. We are going to animate the stroke width, so we'll be working on that. White color is fine for this background, so I will leave it as is, and then I'll change the stroke width to 35. Now you get this very thick and very vibrant white stroke. Now add a keyframe. Make sure the indicator is at the beginning of the timeline. Add a keyframe by clicking on this clock. Now the keyframe has been added. Move this indicator 1 second forward. And reduce this to 0. So now you get this very subtle animation. Okay, once we are done with this, move the indicator to the beginning, and now we need to create circles on this stroke path. So in order to do that, we need to go into the dashes. So click on this plus sign in front of the dashes. Now we have dash and offset. So click one more time this plus sign to display the gap. Okay, we are going to work with the gap and we don't need the dash, so we will make this 0. Okay, now change the line cap from butt to round. Okay, now the circles have been generated, but we cannot see them because the gap is less. So let us increase the gap to show our circles. So here you can see these circles. Now all the circles are there visible. If you want bigger circles, you can just play around with the stroke width. So like if I increase it, you can see the circles get bigger and bigger. If you decrease it, it gets smaller. So for this particular tutorial, I am going to stick with 35, which is an ideal stroke width for this kind of animation. Okay, now we are done with this. Now we have to animate the scale. Okay, the scale property we need to animate. For that we need to go into the transform ellipse. Make sure you are not going into the transform menu. The transform menu also has a scale, and there is this transform ellipse menu which is also having the scale. We are going to work with this particular property and not this scale, because this is specifically for the layer. So whatever changes you make in this, the changes will apply to the entire layer. We don't want that. We just want to scale the ellipse and not scale the entire layer. So now just make sure your indicator is at the beginning of the timeline. Click on the clock to set a keyframe. Now change this 100% to 0, and then move the indicator 1 second forward. Now change it back to 100%. So now your animation is complete. So this is the end result. So you can even duplicate these layers so that you have more than one of such animations. You can just move it here if you want to make it bigger or smaller. Just press S and then scale it up or scale it down. I'll scale it up. Now select another shape layer, move it to this side, and I'll scale this down. Scale this down considerably. So now you get something like this type of animation. Okay, you can also move these forward in the timeline so that they animate at different timelines, and you get this kind of effect. So guys, hope you like this video. If you did like the video, please click on the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Until next time, have a good day.